In this session, we are about to learn about sales order and purchase order, getting advance against an order, tracking the pending orders, and then how do we convert an order to either a delivery challan or to an invoice. So to do this, we'll just take a order from a customer. We'll start from sales order. We'll even see the purchase order also, but first we'll start the sales order flow. So we go to sales order screen. And here we select a custom name, saying let's say Rahul Brothers. Let's say we select product, saying Parker gel pen. And customer is given an order for, let's say we have 40 pieces in our stock, it's shows here. And the customer is given an order for 500 pieces. And for giving a bulk order, see, we even get a previous supply date history at the bottom. So in case, since it's a bulk order, there might be chances where we are reducing the pricing and giving to a customer, some negotiation happen on the pricing part. So let's say we have given an order for, or we have taken accepted order for 45 rupees per pen, and it shows in alert saying sales rate default defined is 50, but we are selling less than the sales rate, so it's okay for us. Any additional discount if we want to provide, we can provide. And let's say we take other products, saying Parker ink pen, 1000 pieces. It even shows the remarks that is mentioned in the product, ink to be refilled after 1 lakh letters, as well as the 220 pieces stock in hand. The remarks is coming from the product master. It can even be configured in the printout if required. Certain instructions can be printed along with an order or even in an invoice. When customer gets an invoice, there can be certain instructions mentioned against each of the product. Either that can be mentioned as a custom columns in the order level, or it can be even linked from the product master. Let's say this has been finalized at the 28 rupees level, and this is the order. See, the advantage with order is whatever quantity that we are giving here, that will be in track, plus the rates that are finalized on the order level, that is the same rates which will be applicable while billing also. So there won't be any confusion. Future, whenever we are supplying against this order, this pricing will be applicable, not the equal pricing. Okay. That is what is the commitment that happens with the sales order, that we have confirmed an order at this level and this pricing, and this is what will be applicable in the future. So once we take an order, let's say customer is given in advance also. So the order value is 55,950. Let's say customer is paid in advance for 5950, a rounded figure. And then there's other details of LR number or any other thing. And you just save this. So once you save it, it will ask you whether it's a cash or is paid by card. If it's a check also, we can configure one more mode of payment here, saying check. And we can accept an amount against it. Let's say a customer is paid by a card or a cash itself, let's just see, 5950, and we save the details. Once an order is entered, the next thing is, let's say we'll order one more quickly. So once we select this, Rajputana, the default salesperson also have come, the one who is associated with this account. That's another Parker gel pen. So we have image along with ink pen, so image is also coming here. Otherwise, just a gel pen. Let's say he has given an order for another 400 pieces. See, last time we have already supplied at 45 rupees for this customer. It's mentioned in the previous history. So it is bringing 45 on its own, but it is even showing an alert saying it's less than 50 rupees. So we still want to give at 45. In case we want to change to 48, let's say this time we have need at 48 rupees, and we are saving this without any advance also. We've just taken an order, let's say a phone order has come, or an order from a website has come, or from email has come. We have just recorded in the system so that we can keep a track of pending orders. Main advantage with order is one person. See, slowly it can even be integrated with e-commerce stores, where any order comes on an online website, even that can be synced here. And let's say phone orders or orders by salesperson who are taking on a mobile app, they also will get synchronized here on the field salesperson. Customers will also have an app in the near future where they'll be able to place their order on their own. They'll be able to see the inventories and they'll be able to place order. All that will get synchronized with the pending orders in the sales order part. The sales order will keep getting generated directly by the salesperson, by the end user, even through the website, and over the phone also someone can receive and enter. Why we are entering order is, one more advantage is, there's no impact on accounts or inventory. unless an advance has come, doesn't impact on accounts. Otherwise, there's no impact on accounts or inventory. We're just mentioning the information on which customer requires what product. Now, based on this order, we can just see a pending order report now. So we go to this pending sales order, and here we can just select account wise, click show. It'll show you which customer, how much value of order is left. So this is the amount worth 55 and 5950 advance we have received. The second order is also pending. When we see show product wise details along, it can even show us the details of. See why these two are coming in red color? Okay. There's an advance commitment that has already come. So based on that, it is showing this. In case if one item has to be cancelled, we can just tick here and click update. Okay. Alternatively, we'll see a few of the things here now. We can see account wise, we can see product wise. When we see product wise, it shows that Parkup and Rajputana we have to supply 400 pieces and Rahul Brothers 500 pieces. Total quantity is 900 which is pending, but we have only 40 in stock. So which means we have to raise a purchase order. Otherwise we won't be able to submit, I mean fulfill the delivery commitment of orders. In sales order we can even mention the delivery date. And other details we have an option saying, no, due date. By when are we delivering the order to the customer? So if you mention the due date here, it will show us a track that customer wants this before this date only. If that date is not there, it will keep on moving. But if the dates are mentioned, then we are sure that within this date if we supply, then the order is acceptable. Beyond that date, it might be customer's choice whether he wants to take it or he doesn't want to take it. So based on that due date, there will be a track of order. Here we can even find out orders which are pending more than 30 days. We can just give number of days and we can give. So it is showing in the OD, the overdue days. It's currently zero since we have entered everything in today's date. So one single report is helping us track which orders are pending from how many days. So if something is pending from more than 7 days, 10 days, then we have to give priority on those first so that we do not miss out on those sales. Otherwise the chances are missing out on sales are more. So we can find out this product wise, account wise, and how do we convert to an invoice. So we can even see double click here and open the product details and the order details. We can even see the plus sign here. The plus sign will show us the adjustment detail. Now there's no adjustment happened. All 400 quantity were ordered and 400 everything is pending. Now let's take in conversion of an order. So let's say this particular order we are converting. If we give make invoice, it will directly convert to a sales invoice. Okay, assuming if we want to convert an order to a challan. See, there are certain scenarios where customer might say that raise one single invoice for entire order. Now there are 400 pieces ordered here, but there are chances where customer might say supply me as and when you get the stock so that I can keep moving with his sales and entire sales, but raise a single invoice. For that scenario we might have to generate multiple delivery challans in between. In order for converting a sales order to a challan, we have to go to file book settings. There's a workflow setup available. So when we say order and we come to this workflow setup, it'll show us like import sales order to where. If your business is directly sales order to invoice only, see certain businesses are very specific. Order should be converted only to invoice in one shot. There's no partial order delivery options available in their premises. So in that scenario, we'll just have only sale invoice. In cases where partial supply is allowed, then we even have to select this option saying convert a sales order to a sale challan also. There are two other options saying sale order can be converted to a stock outward also and sales order can be converted to a purchase order also. Now why do a sales order being converted to a purchase order? This is one more option that we have in Max. In cases where I take order based on catalog basis. I don't have a physical stock in my store but I have catalogs of products and I show the catalog to the customer and take their orders. Immediately once their order is raised, I will raise a purchase order to my vendor as per that catalog. I am linking a sales order to a purchase order. Customer has ordered me 400 pieces. I am converting that sales order to a purchase order for my supplier to supply me 400 pieces. And there are chances where supplier may also not have 400 in stock. He might dispatch us 100, 150 or 200 accordingly. So there will be a track of pending sales order, there will be a track of purchase order that we have raised, and the supplier, the goods that he have supplied against that purchase order, it will be linked with the customer. Finally, customer, when he calls up, we can just mention the order number and find out how much supply has been done, how much is pending. So there can be a link between sales order and a purchase order also. Clear? So I have even opened up an option of import sales order to delivery channel as well as purchase order now. So once we give a make invoice here, I will have to open the screen again. So let's say Rajputana Enterprises. See, now there are two cases here. Either one order will be converted to one invoice only, and certain businesses have a different requirement where multiple orders can be converted to a single invoice. What do you mean by multiple orders? If Rajputana Enterprises have given us 10 different orders on different dates, and then he says whatever we have supplied, raise a bill for that. So I can generate a single invoice with all the supply details of 10 different orders. So how do we handle both the scenarios? First is directly, let's say we are converting single order to a DC or an invoice directly. So it directly converts the entire 400 pieces to a single invoice. Whereas we do not even have stock. If negative inventory is enabled, then it will allow us to build, otherwise it won't allow us to sell this. It is directly being referred. See, there's a color coming here, the serial number, blue color, which means it's a converted one. Somewhere it is linked with some other voucher. And there's a 400 quantity with the order rate that we booked and the other details are coming in. And we're just directly saving it. This is an option where we are converting a direct complete order to a complete invoice. In case of a partial order supply, we can either change the quantity here and we can just mention, let's say out of 400, 250 has been supplied, or how many we have 40 in hand, let's say 40 has been supplied, and we just save this. So once after saving this, we are not sending any SMS and no email, no printing. We come back to pending order report and we click show here. So we will have to remove this 30 days because there's no orders pending for 30 days. So Rajputana, now color has little changed. It's in maroon color. So it says out of 400, it's in execution, 360 is pending. 40 has been supplied, we don't have any stock in hand. And when we open this plus sign, it will show you the adjustment details saying this has been supplied in this particular invoice. The other way of doing this is, let's say we have one more order for Rajputana. So we'll see a separate scenario where a classmate books multiple orders to a single invoice. Let's say 100 books have been ordered at 38 rupees and we are saving this. So when we go to directly sales invoice, and I just mentioned Rajputana Mumbai, it will show a credit. Okay, there are four bills which are beyond the credit days, and it is showing me a pop up with the pending orders. So there are two orders. You are seeing the order reference number, then the one order number is 3, another order number is 2. One is having a classmate 100 pages book pending, other is having a gel pen pending. So in this, I am converting two different orders to a single invoice. Let's say out of this 100 quantity, all 100 are pending. I am just giving 20 out of this, and let's say since there is no stock available here, I still give another. So say quantity is not available, negative inventory is not enabled, so I am not able to use this one. Otherwise you can just proceed with this and you will find two different order details getting loaded on a single invoice. For now I'll just give 0. But the thing is, you have to give quantity whichever you are supplying against multiple orders and click proceed, and all this products which you have selected there will get imported in a single bill, and you can save this. Now how do you find what order has been converted here? You can always go to options, there's some reference reports in which you can find references. This will show you against this particular product, if it's even coming, multiple orders are coming, it will show you product number 1, serial number 1 is coming from this particular sales order. So you can find out which order has been converted to this particular invoice. Same way you can track a sales order to a challan and which challan has been converted here. At one particular voucher, you can find the parent details from where it is coming from. So you can quickly track here and you can double click here and you can even find out the details of the order. You can quickly refer the order also. So that is how simple it is to even track the order details, convert the order and link it to a or convert to an invoice. So you can use make invoice option for converting one single order to one single invoice or a particular challan, or you can use sales invoice option, mention the customer account name, it will show you all the pending orders of that customer. In that scenario, if there are 10 orders also, it will show you all the products of all the 10 orders, and you can mention the quantity which you have supplied and which you are raising bill for. This way multiple orders can be converted to a single invoice. It can be either single invoice or single challan also. Multiple orders, single challan, and then challan can be converted to an invoice. We'll see the delivery challan scenario in a separate session. So this is all about the sales order part here. This one option which we saw was a purchase order against a sales order. So we have seen the pending order report. In pending, same way we go to purchase order. Let's say we are raising an order to, let's say, Deepak Traders. So it is showing me all the pending orders which are taken from different customers. Since I have given an option saying sales order can be imported to purchase order, I am giving any vendor name, all the pending orders are getting loaded. I can just select, see, it is showing Rajpuran, there are two products, Rahul Brothers, there are two products. So what all am I ordering from Deepak Traders against which order? So against this class book, I am ordering 100 pieces for Deepak Traders. Again, this gel pen, I'm ordering, let's say again, 400 to Deepak Traders. Or we can even give partial if you want to see the difference. Let's say here 300 and here 500. So a purchase order has been created, linked with sales order, and we are just saving this. So this we will email the purchase order to the vendor and he will get a confirmation, accordingly he will dispatch the goods. So same way, purchase order is for the vendors. Sales order is which we receive from the customers. Our purchase order is a sales order for our suppliers. Now we can keep a pending track of when all the goods are being supplied to us on different dates. Now a purchase order also, like sales order, can be converted to a single invoice or can be converted to a challan, one order to one challan or one invoice, or alternatively it can be like multiple purchase order can be converted to a single purchase invoice. Okay. So let's say I just go back to this purchase screen and I select, let's say, reference number 777, Deepak Traders. So what all we have ordered from Deepak Traders, all these four details are coming here. Let's say he has supplied 50 out of this, he has supplied 150 out of this, 200 out of this, 400 out of this. So for this, an invoice is getting, a purchase bill is getting generated. And 28,420. This is affecting the inventory as well as it is affecting the accounts. And we are even getting the barcodes generated here for those products as and when they come. You go back to previous and you see reference reports. You can have product price comparison details here. So it says it's coming from purchase order. This particular order number one, all these four products have come from. When you see, go to purchase and see pending purchase orders. Let's say this product details. So it will show you Deepak Traders. There are four different products. Out of first, 50 has been supplied. Out of second, 50 is pending in the first one. Second, 50 is pending. Third, 200 is pending. And fourth, again, 100 is pending. Remaining has been supplied. Now, if this one particular product we no more want it, then we can just select this here and we can click update. So this will get cancelled. It will no more be in the pending list. And for the supplier also, we'll have to intimate this is sufficient. You can keep a track like that way. Same way in purchase order also, if we go to the options and reference details, we'll have a track of the sales order detail. This particular purchase have been converted to purchase, but it has come from this particular sales orders. And wherever we want to open a particular voucher, you can double click and we can open this. So complete clarity of where it has come from, where it has went to. This is two. It has been sent to this particular purchase. And it is coming from a partial sales which has been converted for rational interest, remaining it's from the orders. able to track this. Now what else, what other reports do we have in purchase order? You have already understood purchase order. We can even pay in advance against in purchase order, as well as one order can be converted to one single invoice or delivery challan, or multiple orders can be converted to a single purchase invoice as like sales. Apart from that, we have two additional options in the purchase where you have this rate difference analysis, PO versus purchase, and quantity difference analysis, PO versus purchase. What are these two reports? It's showing nothing. Now let's say I go to this particular purchase bill and I click edit and I change the rate. Instead of, we have ordered at 25 but supplier has given at 30 rupees, and this we have ordered at 40 rupees, supplier has given at 45 rupees. This particular, let's say, there's an option to enable quantity editing while conversion. If we enable that, user will be allowed to edit this quantity. Right now, since it's converted, by default it's locked. Whatever is the quantity where it's imported, that will come from. Let's say I'll just save this 29585. I'll take one more deeper traders. Now class paint, remaining 50 are pending, but supplier has sent us 80. It will still accept. Out of this 100, 120 has been supplied. This one has nothing. And we click proceed. See, order pending was 300 quantities ordered, 100 was only pending, but we've got 120. And for this, we are saving this. So 7904. What has happened? In one case, we have got at different rates. We have ordered for 25 rupees, but we have got at different rates. So it is showing you 50 pieces, rate 30 you have got it, but order rate was 25. Are you able to see on the screen? And difference is 5 rupees. Why the supplier has charged this additional 5 rupees when we have given a commitment order on 25 rupees and order has been raised? So this happens in different scenarios where the chances were. Vendors also do a mistake, or as per their team, they are not aware, or they'll be billing at a different rate. Or we have negotiated and built a better pricing, but they'll send at their default pricing. So in that scenario, the system is helping us to find out what order we have placed at what rate and how much is the rate they have supplied. If there's any difference, it will be shown here. So based on this, we can again raise a debit note, or we can ask discount from the vendor that you have sent us at an additional rate. Able to follow? Same way, the other chances is we have ordered for 100 pieces, but vendor has given us at extra quantity. This happens in many textile stores where they supply, they order for 100 shirts, vendor will sell 150 shirts. Now, if our business is not aware that the vendor is giving it 150, then the team will directly start entering 150, and it will only increase the sales of the vendor, the supplier, I mean the customer's supplier. 100 has been ordered, but 150 has been supplied. Who is responsible? If it's not being tracked by the system, then overstocking happens, and then it's a loss in terms of dead stock, or we will have to push the sales and put discount schemes, unnecessary stock gets added up. So to track that also, we have a report where we can even find out quantity difference analysis between PO versus purchase. So here the pending quantity for this was 80. This report, basically this report will show you this only, quantity difference analysis. Order quantity 100, but supplied 120, so difference quantity of 20. This way we can either tell supplier saying we are putting a purchase return, we have to return the goods back, or we'll ask for an initial discount, or whatever it is. But we have a track at least that more quantity has been supplied rather than whatever we have ordered. So purchase versus, PO versus purchase, rate difference analysis, and PO versus purchase, quantity difference analysis. Both these are important report for ensuring that overstocking is avoided, or at least the rates, whatever we have negotiated at, that is being kept in track. So this was all about orders. What all we have summarized, I'll just summarize this on the order part. Sales order and purchase order, both are similar. Sales order for our customers and purchase order we raise for our suppliers for buying the goods. sales order, once a customer raises an order, we can get an advance against it, and order is not having any impact on accounts and inventory. Any impact on accounts and inventory means it won't change anything in accounts and inventory. Accounts part can be changed. If we receive an advance, it will definitely increase the account balances. Otherwise, there's no changes. Order is a very important feature in terms of connectivity. Now, sales people from field, customers, website, everything can be incorporated. And from everywhere, we can get the orders synchronized to the spending orders. From there, we can have a track of how much purchase we need to make so that we can deliver these goods on a timeline. Against the sales order, we can have pending order track product wise, we can see pending orders vendor wise, and we can see orders how many days wise, basically how many days the order has not been supplied. Particular orders which are the red color which was coming there, it was basically on the due date. If the order has to be supplied on that date itself, it will show you an alert in the pending order report that the due date is the same day.
Blue color.
Red color.
Blue color was invoice.
Partial conversion, that will be in the invoice screen. Same way, purchase order, we are having a track of, we can even link sales order to a purchase order and have a track of against which sales order, what purchase order we have raised, and how much goods have been supplied against that particular sales order. Purchase order, we have additional two options. PO versus purchase pending analysis, and see, this is coming in red color because the due date is the same date. The order was placed on 12th and the due date is also 12th, so it's on high priority, basically has to be supplied immediately. Remaining, it's on 12th, but the date of supply is, we have time till 11/1/2018. As per the due date, is showing you the colors here. Same way, purchase, pending purchase order, one order can be converted to a one invoice. We can even have a lock on that, or multiple orders can be converted to a single invoice or single challan, and we can even link that. In purchase, we have two additional options where we can track purchase versus PO versus purchase rate difference analysis and PO versus purchase quantity difference analysis to avoid overstocking or other rate differences. That's all with the sales order. We'll start this session here. Thank you.